working on three projects, which I think are all relevant to deliberative processes. The first is called the deliberatorium, and it's a system which asks crowds to interact using a kind of question and answer structure. So instead of simply using a kind of reply structure like in email or in web forms, it asks them to structure what they want to say in the form of questions to be answered, in terms of potential answers for those questions, and in terms of arguments about whether those are answers are good ones or bad ones. And it turns out that adding a little bit of structure to the discussion allows the crowd to create an output which is much more organized and compact and complete. So it helps avoid the problem that often if you go to crowds and ask for ideas, you get a lot of noise and it's very disorganized. So that's one project. The second project is called the Bag of Lemons, and the goal of that is to take a large set of ideas and use the crowd to pick the better ideas from that list. And it's based on the maybe counterintuitive idea that people are actually faster and more accurate at eliminating bad ideas than they are at picking good ones. And so that's the trick we use, and our experiments have shown that the crowd is in fact much more accurate, as well as about three times faster if they use the bad idea elimination approach rather than trying to select good ideas. And also we think it has advantages in that often with difficult, very controversial topics, the important thing is to eliminate the ideas that somebody hates. So at least all the ideas that are left over are at least okay for everybody. So I think we think it's a good match for tough disputes. So that's the second project. The third project is in the realm of negotiation. Now, if you're negotiating over a simple topic, for example, I'm going to sell you a book and we're negotiating about the price, then it turns out that a very simple procedure works perfectly well. I start at a high price and you start at a low price and we kind of bargain towards the middle. And that's provably optimal. But it turns out that for complex problem solving, where there's many issues, like in social policy, and where the issues affect each other, the choice for one issue affects how much you like the choice for another issue. In that case, bargaining is actually a very bad way to come to agreements, because what usually happens is that we end up with agreements that are worse for both of us, just because of the particular process we used. And in particular, we found that to negotiate effectively with complex processes, there needs to be more room for exploration, even in directions which, at least temporarily, may seem worse for me or may seem worse for you. But as a result of that, we have a better chance of finding solutions which are better for both of us. But it's just not a straight line. So those are the three main projects I'm working on, and I think they're certainly relevant to the different phases of deliberative democracy. The kind of work that I'm have heard the most about is where cities are using the crowd as a kind of extended sensory system in order to identify problems in the city. So there are systems like C-Click-Fix or I forget the name of the other one, which apparently is being used in Spain. But in any case, the goal of these systems are for people to report problems in the city, like a hole in the road or a water leaking or stuff like that. And as a result, the city can gather much more accurate information about what needs to be fixed for essentially free. The same kind of approach is used to gather, let's say, water quality data, stuff like that. So that's the most common successful approach that I know of. In addition to that, there has been some work in terms of including the crowd in the development of policy. So, for example, in places like Brazil, and also I heard also in New York, there's been a process called participatory budgeting, where a crowd of people are given a budget by the city, and that they generate a set of ideas, they rank the ideas, and they decide how that budget gets spent. And that seems to be growing in popularity as well. I'm less aware of work where citizens are involved actively in defining legislation. There have been some tools and some attempts to do that, for example, with the Icelandic constitution, but it seems like that's still at the beginning of the life cycle. I don't know the full range of work that's been done in this area. I think that there's a relatively small number of examples to date. As I mentioned, there's the Icelandic constitution. Off the top of my head, I don't have any other examples in mind. There have been other attempts to do it. For example, in Australia, there was an effort to engage people in defining the rules for how the police operate. And so the proposed laws were put on a website and people can add comments to that. There have been several efforts like that, but unfortunately those efforts have failed because the number of comments that has come in has been so huge that it's been almost impossible to summarize them and to get some useful ideas about what to do. So I think for policy design we still need better tools for compressing the input of the crowd into something that's useful for the policymakers.